So I'm going to request Ms. Sandhya Mam.
Touch to the core of her being, compelling her to lose herself in his eyes. Unable to stop herself, she reached out and touched his lips. He gasped, sucking in his breath. Cut, screamed the director. What a scene, great chemistry, madam. Sir, you were fantastic. The superstar brushed off the dirt and leaves from his peachy Arabic costume. Chivalrous as always, he held out his arm to help the heroine out, thinking, God bless and Rajnikanth.
Thank you. So now I would like theatre and film actor Vandana Sajnani Khattar to please read a passage. She's not yet come. Alright, fine. Let's move on. We will now be inviting questions from the audience. Please. Please.
Read the introduction, which says, some of the first images that came to my mind when I was told to write the story of the superstar were these. Actor, robot, dark, carpenter, rowdy, bus conductor, god, mediation, yoga, tufts of grey, Amitabh Bachchan, Jayalalitha, Madrasi, politician. However, the most untouched and the most intriguing facet of this man, who holds a godlike status amongst many, seems to be his spirituality. Spirituality as opposed to his lifestyle, his films, and his notorious earlier years. But then, which of them depicted the real Rajnikanth? To know more, read the book.
I would like to Vandana Sajnani Khattar to come on stage and read a passage, please.
Good evening, everybody. I'm late because when Sajid is around, nobody gets a chance to talk. So I let him have his fill and then I take over. Anna? Really? Okay. Congratulations, Seema. What do you want me to start? Sachin. Jason's terrified eyes travel along with the spinning object. Now metal, now wood. Thus he stood transfixed, his body tense, his arms outstretched. His hands cupped in front of himself. Nervous anticipation writ on his sweaty face. Cotton out, shouted the boy, who bowled across his goodwin, although the mischief and challenge dancing in his eyes was short-lived. Ow! He yelled, as he felt his ear being twisted. It was Sudhakar, the shop owner. Shivaji worked for him part-time. Sir, please, he grinned in spite of his pain, let go of my ear. Your ear, is it? Sudhakar sneered, twisting it further. It hurts, right? Desim could have been killed with that hammer. Then who'd feed his family? Who'd make up for the loss of work here? You? A good for nothing? Disgusted, he pushed the youngster aside. I'd heard people say that Rambai had given birth to Darky, but you, you're black inside out. The physical hurt ceased to exist as his spiteful words overtook all else. A piercing pain blazed a fiery path from deep within Shivaji's gut up to his tearful eyes. Smacking his fist into the palm of his hand, he looked away to control his wrath, but with slow deliberation, he turned around to face Sudhakar. Sir, he said, if you have the guts, let's split open your fair skin and my black skin. Let's see if your blood is white or red, like mine. Sudhakar shrunk back from the power of those bloodshot eyes as if physically hit. The explosive moment passed when the 60-year-old Kumar, Sudhakar's senior-most employee, intervened softly. Sudhakar, sir, let it be. He's still young. Lord Krishna was dark, and weren't Shiva and Rama dark too? So why target this child? Sudhakar, relieved at the chance to look at it from the menace in Shivaji's eyes, retorted, how can you compare this idiot to Lord Rama and Krishna? They are gods. This boy is an ignorant ruffian. Shivaji flicked black and oily lock of hair failing across his eyes. He glared at Sudhakar, and then, to the amazement of all, he burst out laughing. What the... Sudhakar's face turned bright red with anger. The unpredictability of youth taking over, Shivaji replied with ill-disguised mirth. Lord Krishna was naughty, right? Shiva was the destroyer, and Rama too was influenced by many. Lost in thought, he continued, albeit in a softer tone. And yet they fought several wars in this world, as also the wars raging within themselves. His eyes glazed over. He was conscious of nobody in the small, dusty workshop until, straightening his back with resolve, he announced, I too am a warrior, and I will be victorious. You watch. All stood silent. All stood still. Only the fine sawdust particles danced as if energized with the rays of the setting sun, transmitted into magical gold dust before settling onto Shivaji's determined eyes. Jason, the actual witness and the accidental cause of this furor, could not help but stare at Shivaji with unconcealed awe.
Thank you, sir. So now we'll be inviting questions from the audience, please. Anybody? You can raise a hand and I'll pass on the mic.
But Rajnikanth, because why not Rajnikanth actually? He is such a big superstar. And the thing is, when I was, I had just completed my previous project, and I was just browsing the net, and I came across a picture of him sitting in this cave, dark cave, you know, with an overnight stubble and meditating. And it really intrigued me, you know, and I said, I have to delve deeper and find out more about this person whom everybody knows as the man who flips his cigarettes up and who throws his glasses and all that gimmickry. I just thought this was a side that people don't know about. And I started writing, and I love the whole process of writing about him. Thank you.
That leads to my second question. Have you met him?
I haven't met him, but his brother. His older brother, Mr. Satyanarayan Rao Gaikwad. In fact, when I began writing this book, I tried to get in touch with him. There were a lot of people around him, and they said he was not well. He had just come back from Singapore that time, so he couldn't meet anybody. And I was on the verge of giving up writing about, you know, him, because there were so many obstacles. But then something happened. It was destined to be. I met his brother, his older brother, who's brought him up. And I went to their home, and he told me, I think I'm talking on Rajnikanth's behalf. And he wrote a note in this book, you know, and it was very beautiful. Thank you.
Anybody else? Yes.
Like I said earlier, that there is a warrior within all of us, whether man or woman, whether superstar or common man. So I think if you need to know who the warrior within is, one has to just look at yourself, inner self, and probably find the answer. We're all fighting something in life, and we're all happy also. But yeah, the warrior within is all of us. All of us, yeah. Thank you.
I just met him two times. Once when I was like 14 or 15, I bumped my 10th standard exam because there was a nightclub called Xanadu in Hotel Horizon. So I used to go there and break dance because free entry milti thi tabhi. But I remember he was shooting, I think, for one of the, he did a lot of Bollywood films, and I think he was staying in Hotel Horizon. So he came down from the room just to go to the nightclub, because everybody was going to the nightclub, but he was wearing a churidar kurta and he was wearing chappal. So I think the bouncer stopped him At that minute, the bouncer did not realize who he was talking. You see, in the 80s, superstar Rajnikanth was not really a superstar. He became a superstar in the mid-90s. You know, then this whole magic of the most imitated man, perhaps after Charlie Chaplin, on the planet, you know. I mean, I've seen 5, 6, 7-year-old kids who probably not seen his movies, but they also imitate him. They imitate his mannerisms. So he stopped him from entering. And all I remember was Rajni sir very nicely said, okay, I'll go and wear chappals, I'll wear my shoes and come back. The manager came running out. The manager came and he started firing the security guy, the bouncer. Okay, how can you stop him? So he told him, no, it's not his fault. He's only doing his job. That's the time I realized, my God, such a big star and such a down-to-earth, humble person. That's the only time I remember actually seeing him as a child. And then once I met him, I was shooting in Hyderabad. So I briefly met him for like 10 seconds. And those 10 seconds, I was down at his feet. I'm like a mad fan of all these guys. और अगर बना सकते हैं तो why not? Ambitiously सबको सोचना ही चाहिए. But I don't think वो कोई ऐसी फिल्म करेंगे बॉलीवुड में जो उनके बारे में ना हो. और उनके बारे में फिल्म बनाने के लिए मतलब आपको 250, 300, 400 करोड़ का बजट चाहिए होगा. प्लस इतनी केयरफुली उनकी हर पिक्चर को बनाना पड़ता है क्योंकि उनके इतने सारे फैंस हैं. He has to be portrayed absolutely correct. क्या होता है? बहुत कम बार ना एक्टर फिल्म के ऊपर हो जाता है. रजनीकांत इज दैट एग्जांपल. जब आप फिल्म देखने नहीं जा रहे हो, आप उनको देखने जा रहे हो और उनकी इर्द गिर्द फिल्म चल रही है, यू नो, तो उनकी अगर फिल्म फ्लॉप भी होती है तो भी पैसा रिकवर कर लेती है, यू नो. तो बहुत मुश्किल होगा अगर उनके साथ बैठ के कोई प्रॉपर फिल्म बनाए. तो हैट्स ऑफ टू डायरेक्टर्स लाइक शंकर एंड ऑल फॉर प्रेजेंटिंग हिम इन मूवीज लाइक रोबो एंड शिवाजी द बॉस, यू नो. सो दैट्स इट. जैसे मैंने कहा जोक्स के साथ ना, आज की डेट में जोक्स एक फैड हो गया है. मुझे लगता है कि पिछले 2 साल में अगर मुझे 1 रुपया मिलता एक हम शक्ल के जोक के ऊपर तो आज मैं करोड़पति होता. तो वो एक फैड हो गया. आई थिंक वो एंड नाउ दीज आर द टाइम्स वी लिव इन. सो वन मस्ट लर्न टू लिव एंड लाफ. आई एम श्योर उन्होंने भी सुने होंगे उनके बारे में जोक्स, बट आई डोंट थिंक ही मस्ट बी चार्जिंग मनी फॉर दैट. बट आई थिंक जोक्स तभी होते हैं जब आप पॉपुलर होते हो, और पॉपुलैरिटी आपकी तभी बढ़ती है जब आप चर्चे में आते हो और लोग आपके बारे में बात करते हैं, भले वो अच्छी बातें करें बुरी बातें करें, यू नो. लाइक दे से ना, देयर इज नो सच थिंग एज बैड न्यूज और गुड न्यूज, इट्स ऑलवेज गुड न्यूज पीपल टॉक अबाउट. तो आई थिंक और आई थिंक आज की डेट में थोड़े जोक्स कम भी हो गए, यू नो, गवर्नमेंट के ऊपर ज़्यादा हो रहे हैं जोक्स.
I also really want to thank all the celebrities out here, the people on the dais, the awarded CD team, the Tidal Waves bookstore team will be served outside the bookstore.
Center.
Yes, ma'am, look here.
Ma'am, shade.
Sir, Rajit sir,
sir, right,
ma'am. Sir, I'm extremely honored ke mujhe ye kitab unveil karne ko bulaya gaya hai. And just because it's about him that I'm here, and you know, the warrior within the book, I think Seema's done a fantastic job. Whatever I read from the book or heard from the book, and I'm dying to go home and read it because I am truly one of his biggest fans, if not the biggest. आप दो अलग ओशंस को कंपेयर कर रहे हैं कि कौन सी ओशन ज़्यादा गहरी है, कौन सी ओशन ज़्यादा वास्ट है. आई थिंक बहुत अनफेयर होगा कंपेयर करना अमिताभ बच्चन हु इज़ अ लिविंग लेजेंड विद रजनीकांत हु इज़ अ लिविंग लेजेंड superstar. Both of them are superstars in their own rights, and both of them have immense fan following and immense love and immense respect. So I think un dono ko compare karna, I think wo dono ko agar aap puchein, agar aap Rajnikant sir ko puchein ki kaun hai bada superstar, to I'm sure he'll say Shri Amitabh Bachchan, and Amit ji ko puchein to wo bolenge Shri Rajnikant.
Aapko kabhi aisa laga ki Rajnikant ko wo due nahi mila Bollywood mein?
Nahi, but mere hisab se bahut logon ko Bollywood mein wo due nahi mila jo regional cinema mein unko mila. बट जिस तरह से रजनी सर को ड्यू मिला है और जिस तरह से उन्होंने रीजनल सिनेमा को वर्ल्ड वाइड प्रेजेंट किया है, इस कलेक्शंस आर आई थिंक एज गुड एज जैकी चैन एज एन एशियन सुपरस्टार.
सीमा, आप क्या कहना चाहेंगे? जो अभी एक सवाल पूछा कि बॉलीवुड में ड्यू, आर यू रिटन अ बुक टुडे, व्हाट डू यू हैव टू से अबाउट हिज ऑरा इन बॉलीवुड?
रजनीकांत, यस, रजनीकांत डिड ट्राई, उन्होंने कोशिश की थी कि 80s में फिल्म्स करने की बॉलीवुड में, लेकिन समहाउ बुक में लिखा हुआ है कि उनको उनको इतना पसंद नहीं किया नॉर्थ इंडियंस ने. एक उनके लुक, उनके स्टाइल्स, उनके मैनरिज्म्स ज़्यादा शायद नॉर्थ इंडियंस बॉम्बे आइट्स को पसंद नहीं आए. बट द थिंग इज़ एक्चुअली कि रजनीकांत इज़ अ महाराष्ट्रियन, एंड यू नो ही कुड स्पीक हिंदी वेल, बट वो एक्सेंट आता था. उन्होंने एक जगह बोला है, मैं जब बैंगलोर में जाता हूँ तो मुझे महाराष्ट्रन बोलते हैं, जब मैं बॉम्बे में जाता हूँ तो मुझे मद्रासी बोलते हैं, और मद्रास में मुझे मराठी बोलते हैं, तो मैं कहाँ जाऊँ, मैं हूँ कौन, यू नो दैट्स द थिंग. सो
आप अपना एक्सपीरियंस अगर बताएं तो एक फेवरेट चीज़ जो आपने जानी रजनीकांत की, जो ऑडियंस जानना चाहे.
एक फेवरेट चीज़ रजनीकांत की, आई थिंक इट वुड बी, आई कांट से ब्लू लेबल, बट आई विल से his spirituality, और उनका जो उनके जिनसे भी मैंने बात की, उन्होंने कहा कि रजनीकांत हैज़ नो ईगो. वो बहुत ही डाउन टू अर्थ है, ही हैज़ नो ईगो, इसीलिए वो कुछ भी पहन के कहीं भी आ सकते हैं, एंड वी स्टिल लव हिम. सो दैट इज़ द थिंग अबाउट रजनीकांत.
बॉलीवुड में या साउथ में
आई थिंक अगर जितना ही बड़ा मैं फ़ैन रजनी सर का हूँ, आई थिंक उतना ही बड़ा फ़ैन मैं कमला हासन जी का भी. मैं कमला हासन साहब का बहुत बड़ा फ़ैन हूँ, उनकी कोई भी फिल्म मिस नहीं करता हूँ. तो आई थिंक उनकी लाइफ भी एक बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग किताब है, बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग. व्हाट डू यू फील?
एब्सोल्युटली,
दैट शुड बी योर नेक्स्ट बुक.
या एब्सोल्युटली, बिकॉज रजनीकांत एंड कमल हसन एक पैरेलल चलते रहे, और उनके फैंस की वजह से उनको दे कुडंट वर्क टुगेदर आफ्टर सर्टेन आफ्टर 1980s.
And both, I think, were introduced by K. Balachandran.
Absolutely. Yeah. K. Balachandran introduced both of them, one as a villain, one as a hero.
साजिद नडेडवाला के साथ साजिद नडेडवाला एंड साजिद खान और बैंक नेक्स्ट ईयर.